The terminal is always in a love-hate relationship with Neovim. Is Neovim a terminal app, or is the terminal a Neovim process? Is multiplexing the way to go, or mapping commands from within the IDE is the right thing? There are too many ways to go, with pros and cons, and the choice paradox here is hitting hard. So today, we're going to put things in order, once and for all, by covering all options, comparing them, and making some decisions around them. Whether you're new to Vim or Neovim or a seasoned engineer, I'm sure you're going to find something new, so stick around and please do add missing options in the comments if you feel you know something else. With that in mind, let's jump into Neovim and the terminal. We can't really start this process without touching the obvious option of all, the NVim terminal emulator. There are several ways to create a terminal buffer. Run the terminal command within Neovim, or call the NVim option term, or term open function. Let's start with a simple command that opens a terminal shell right inside the editor. Once in insert mode, it feels just like using a regular terminal where all the commands are available, as if you were outside of Neovim. I can run my favorite listing tool, Eza, and even enjoy the syntax highlighting I love. None of this is lost, even though this is just Neovim wrapping the emulator. To exit the shell, the straightforward option is to end the session with Ctrl-D, which closes the pen entirely. A more refined approach, perhaps a key reason to run an emulator within Neovim, is to exit the terminal without closing it. This is done by pressing Ctrl-backslash, followed by Ctrl-N. Sounds complicated, and it definitely can be. So let's simplify it by remapping these commands. We'll use the prefix T for the mapping, that stands for a terminal mode map, where pressing escape triggers the same key combination. Now with a single press of escape, I can exit the terminal, switch to another pane, and continue using Neovim without losing any terminal content. This is particularly handy when you're using the terminal to gather data that you later want to edit in Neovim, instead of relying on a multiplexer or some other method to capture and transfer the terminal's history. Using Neovim's built-in emulator means the content is already there, ready for editing. Another helpful trick is to configure a key mapping for moving around the terminal emulator, similar to navigating through panes in Tmux. For example, you can map Alt-H to move to the left split. This is done by setting it to trigger an escape sequence, followed by Ctrl-W, which is Neovim's command for window management, and then H for the left motion. Once set up, while using the emulator, pressing Alt-H will jump to the left split. If you find yourself frequently using this feature, it's a good idea to add these to the terminal mode motions so you can move freely across the pane splits. Moving on to another option that I found more natural, a floating terminal. Neovim supports a community plugin called Floaterm that I've used for a couple of years. Recently, I switched my setup, which I'll detail later, but Floaterm remains a great tool. It offers the simple functionality of a floating persistent terminal that can easily be toggled on top of your code. You can launch Floaterm either empty or with a command like fzf, for example. This capability opens up several possibilities, such as mapping a floating FZF search with a dedicated key binding, or using it to start any other process you might need. Additionally, Floaterm allows you to control the height and width of the window, as well as its name, position, and even includes an option to automatically close the terminal when the process ends. Imagine Yazi running inside a small box, positioned in the lower left-hand corner, closing itself as soon as you exit the process. We've discussed an internal emulator and an NVim internal floating pane, and now it's time to step outside of Neovim and explore multiplexers. Tmux is my multiplexer of choice, but there are other viable options like multiplexing features in Wesderm, Kitty, and many other emulators that offer their own split window functionality. With Tmux, you can create and rearrange splits, but you can also manage entire sessions by opening new windows filled with various panes. There's also a Tmux pop-up feature similar to Floaterm, which can run a process and automatically close when that process finishes. You can see the influence Floaterm drew from Tmux pop-ups here. Tmux adds another layer of organization with its sessions, allowing you to separate environments by hosting their own sets of windows. Since Tmux itself doesn't provide robust session control bindings or tools, I created Session X, a fuzzy picker and manager for sessions based on FZF. This tool allows users to swiftly and easily navigate, create, rename, delete, and more. You can learn more about Session X in the project's GitHub page and in my video linked above. The main reason I prefer using Tmux over internal Neovim emulator is the persistency of the shell. While I often open and close multiple Neovim sessions during my work, the Tmux server remains active. Exiting a Vim session doesn't affect my other running shells, which simplifies my workflow. I use Neovim for coding and Tmux for managing shells, keeping them separate. I want to take a quick break to tell you about GiveInternet.org. Almost 3 billion people have never logged onto the internet. They've never taken advantage of Google, YouTube, or the AI tools we use today. They've missed out on education, online jobs, conversations, and equal opportunities. And we've missed on their potential. Before the internet, a person's future was determined by the physical environment they were born in. Today, internet access means access to global knowledge and equal opportunities. At GiveInternet.org, you can sponsor internet fees and laptops for students from some of the underserved communities. Their local partners provide skills development programs like coding, design, healthcare, and entrepreneurship. The only thing the students lack are internet connection and a laptop. Once connected, most of them find either a job, freelance, or start their own business. Join the cause in a few clicks. Every donation made through giveinternet.org/devops toolbox will be matched by some of the donors. You can read the story of every student on the platform, view every penny spent, and receive monthly updates showing you who you helped and how you changed their lives. Now back to the video. Another remarkable multiplexing tool is Zellige, a modern and visually appealing project I've previously covered. It features a familiar system like Tmux with tabs, splits, and sessions, but adds unique elements like floating panes grouped together. For more details, check out Zellige on its projects page and my videos for both beginners and Tmux experienced users. Zooming out a little further, let's return to the basics of running processes. Operating Vim or nvim in a terminal allows the process suspension like any other application. Using Ctrl-Z puts the process in the background, and you can toggle between background and foreground with BG and FG commands. This method is simple, requires no extra tools, and is available on every host. It's a timeless approach, often used by many engineers to maintain both their shell and Vim sessions without loss. Similarly, Vim and nvim can interact directly with the shell. Running a command from the colon prompt, starting with a bang, executes a Unix shell command. The output is shown, and you can press a key to return to your editing. This integration means you can perform tasks like creating files, listing them, or writing content directly from Neovim, with std out being displayed as a message via Neovim, in this case using Vim Notify. It's particularly useful for editing data, like sorting a list of lines or prettifying a JSON structure with JQ, which then sends a structure version back to the editor. Lastly, I'd like to introduce my latest workflow upgrade called FloaX, a new Tmux plugin that introducing floating panes in a terminal functionality. FloaX isn't just a floating pane, it integrates deeply with Tmux, offering persistent sessions, full window management, and history retention. It's adaptable, it allows you to control the size, style, and even enter full screen mode. If you appreciate FloaX, consider supporting it with a star on GitHub. It's a new project and that could use more visibility. Contributions are also welcome, whether you add tests, issue reports, or pull requests. Stay tuned for a video covering all that FloaX has to offer. Make sure you're subscribed and don't forget to hit the bell icon to be notified when the video goes live. So by now, I'm pretty sure it's clear. There's no one size fits all, there's no right, there's no wrong. There's workflow and choices around it. My guiding light has always been the path with least friction, the path with minimal resistance. It works for water, it should work for me. As you've seen, 9 out of 10 times it's going to be Tmux for me. It's always there, I know it by heart, and I made sure it's built around my needs and tailored to my workflow. So watch this next one to get yourself started properly and set your Tmux environment like a pro. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.